The United States, for 24 years, has dropped bombs on Iraq. And now President Obama, who came into office in 2009 with the promise to end the war in Iraq, is asking Congress to authorize an endless war, including the continued bombing of Iraqi cities and towns, this time with a new rationale, a new pretext. In 1990, the pretext for bombing Iraq was Kuwait. For the next 10 years, the pretext for economic sanctions that killed a million Iraqis died because they were deprived food and medicine, was so that Saddam Hussein would be forced to give up weapons of mass destruction, which we know he did not have by then. And then in 2003, Bush and Cheney said, no, we must invade Iraq in order to keep America safe, to prevent another 9/11. None of that was true. And now President Obama and the right-wing war lobby in Congress are saying, well, there's another reason. There's another reason to bomb Iraq, and that is to stop the Islamic State. We are here today, sisters and brothers, to say very clearly that we, the American people, know the only reason the Islamic State, so-called, exists in Iraq is because the United States has been bombing their country for the past 24 years. The way to stop the Islamic State is not to drop more U.S. bombs, but to get the U.S. the hell out of Iraq, to leave Iraq alone, to let Iraq become self-determining, to let the Iraqi people do what they did for thousands of years, which is to control their own destiny. The Iraqi people don't need the benevolent, democratic bombs and missiles from the Pentagon. They need those who orchestrated the invasion of Iraq, like Bush and Cheney and Rumsfeld and Powell and Condoleezza Rice, to be held accountable for their crimes, to be arrested and prosecuted and imprisoned for their crimes against humanity in Iraq and elsewhere. And we join them in that demand. We are here today because unless we act, we know that Congress will, either through explicit authorization or acquiescence, allow this government to bomb Iraq for another 24 years. We won't stand for it. Thank you, sisters and brothers. Help pick up a coffin, pick up a sign. Let's make this protest loud and strong and visible. Thank you.